is all right.
We haven't heard any report of a lost boy.
Can you help us find him? The city's so big.
Well, perhaps in the morning I can spare a few men.
In the morning? What about tonight?
We aren't paid to find runaway boys.
Jesus didn't run away. He's lost. I think there would be something you could do.
It's all right, Mary. It's all right. Thank you. We'll come in the morning. He's about this tall, and his name is Jesus.
No.
The last time we saw him was at the North Gate, but that was 3 days ago.
We haven't seen him.
Jesus!
Why was the law given?
To teach us what is wrong in the sight of God.
Yes, but more important than knowing what is wrong is doing what is right.
Jesus! Mary!
I hope you don't mean to suggest that the law is useless.
No, I suppose not. But what if the law could be fulfilled?
Fulfilled?
Yes, fulfilled by love. What would happen if we loved others like we love ourselves? More than we love ourselves. We would be filled with mercy and compassion. The law is good, but it cannot change our heart. For a man may love the law and hate his brother. But when love fills our heart, then we have fulfilled the law.
Yes.
Mother.
Oh, Jesus. Where have you been? Your father and I looked everywhere for you.
We've been to every house and market in Jerusalem.
Why have you sought me so? Didn't you know I'd be about my father's business?
Huh? Will you come home, Jesus?
There, Jesus grew strong in spirit and was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him.
Golden rays of sunlight shining from above fill my soul with gladness, fill my heart with love. Moon and stars will echo
Oh.
kingdom. Dawn reveals its glow, growing into dazzling daylight, warming all below. His love shines around me.
This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased.
Jesus was then led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where he sought wisdom from the Lord through fasting.
And still he lives. He has great strength indeed. You need help.
No.
But you'll die soon.
I will not die until I have performed the will of my father.
Your father?
The Lord God.
If you're the Son of God, so
I will suffer far worse than this for the sake of God's love.
Prove it to me. Here. Now. Take and turn them into bread. Come on. Your hunger will be satisfied. In fact, I will fall down and worship you forevermore.
It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. I know who you are, and you know who I am.
They are the people you've come to save. But first, they must believe. It is written, God shall command his angels to protect you, even from hitting your foot upon a stone. I have a plan. Throw yourself off. When they see the angels save you, then they'll believe. Then they will know you're the Son of God.
You say it is written that I shall be saved.
It is.
It is also written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God.
Prepared to give it all to you.
It is not yours to give.
It is mine to give. It is mine. The people of this world obey my voice, for I have power. Power as you have never seen.
Satan, get thee hence, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve.
And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee, and there went out a fame of him through all the region round about.